Steven Universe has never been the show to give its characters a happy ending. Instead, the ending seemed to be at best bittersweet, with a focus instead on poetically summing up real-life situations and accepting them for what they are, projected against a sci-fi fantasy backdrop. It was never the show where the couple stays together, where the villain gets redemption, or every problem gets perfectly solved. What little we saw in the way of happy endings, such as Steven's self-actualization, are being broke down in the new epilogue series, Steven Universe Future, showing us that while those moments were happy, they certainly aren't the end of the characters' journeys. This, of course, raises the question, how exactly will the series end? Particularly in regards to Steven and his volatile emotional state, as well as discovering what his new purpose will be now that the whole galaxy has been saved from the Gempire by him. Steven's subconscious summarizes the question perfectly in the episode In Dreams, where it manifests as a giant cookie cat face that asks Steven, "No one needs your help, so why are you still here?" And while it may ultimately be that Steven needs to learn that he can exist without helping people, that he can take the time to be helped instead of focusing on everyone else's problems, I think the end of the question really highlights how the show itself will end, with Steven needing to leave Beach City, possibly for good. We're going to break down all of the reasons why, but first I want to remind you all to check out our new channel, Geek Galaxy. It's our new spin-off channel where we'll be talking about all things geeky that don't quite fit in with the cartoon theme of Cartoon Universe. We currently have a video up about the decline of Sonic the Hedgehog, and we'll be posting another video this Saturday about why so many anime copy Naruto, with two new videos coming out every week with similar subjects. So if you're interested in that, I'll put a link in the comments down below. Go down, check it out, and don't forget to subscribe. The most interesting evidence for this actually comes from an interview with Zach Callison, where he talks about how his real-life journey matches Steven's arc in Steven Universe Future perfectly. In this same interview, he explains that once he finishes working on Steven Universe, he will be leaving the industry to travel the world for several years. There is plenty of evidence for this within the show as well. All of his friends are moving on. Every one of the Sadie Killer and the Suspects are launching brand new careers as their band starts to dissolve. The Crystal Gems have found a new purpose with their duties in Little Homeworld that they seem to love, finally giving them a chance to share their form of existence with other gems who never had the same opportunity. Lars is returning to space with the Off-Colors, and Connie and Steven are very likely going to break up if the theories about Together Forever are any indication. With everyone breaking up and moving on to do their own things, Steven will have the opportunity to do the same himself. This is something Future has been setting up from the very beginning. From the very first title sequence where we can see Beach City in the rearview mirror as Steven drives away. This is bookended with the closing credits where we see what appears to be Steven driving away from Beach City yet again. The song that plays while Steven drives away is also subtly hinting at this ending. This should be no surprise. After all, the previous ending theme, Love Like You, seemed to foreshadow the ending of the first series perfectly, as well as summing up the entire show. And we see a similar relationship developing between the show and this new ending theme, Being Human. The first set of lyrics are particularly telling. Just a little time, just a little something else instead. As if Steven is talking about taking time away from Beach City to try something new, particularly trying to be human, as the title of the song suggests. After all, the series thus far has been him mostly exploring his gem half, and now he has a chance to explore his human side more thoroughly. He can travel the world instead of traveling the galaxy. And what better way to do that than following in his father's footsteps, leaving his home with nothing but his car, and going out into the world to find his own idea of what happiness will be, and maybe even a new home along the way. This ending may seem sad to fans, but the whole point of the series so far is that it doesn't have to be. All of the other characters are moving on and moving away, but this doesn't invalidate the happy endings from the previous series. These moments were still important and impactful for the characters, but your life's journey doesn't stop at such a young age. Instead, you take those happy moments with you into the future as you search for what is going to make you happy next, and Steven will do the same. It's a fitting ending for Steven's conundrum of finding out what to do next with his life. But some of you may be wondering how this will tie into the bigger plot he's been experiencing, his uncontrollable bouts of Pink Diamond rage that are ruining his life and putting everyone around him in danger. Him leaving town may seem like a bad way to deal with his emotional issues, but it might be more appropriate than you think. One thing we know for certain is that Pink Diamond was once seemingly just as full of rage as Steven. We saw this first in flashbacks on the Jungle Moon, and Pink Pearl confirmed that her outbursts were so dangerous it led to her physical form being permanently damaged. The surprising thing about this, of course, is that Pink Diamond and Rose Quartz were seen as being gentle, not violent. Even Pearl found the revelations of her past violence to be shocking. Pink Diamond was like Steven, someone prone to violent outbursts that could hurt others, but something caused her to change. As of now, there seemed to be two key elements that led to that change. First, being that she realized just how serious her problem was when she hurt someone else. Pink Pearl described their relationship as loving despite the violence, and seeing how her outbursts hurt Pink Pearl likely was the wake-up call Pink Diamond needed to make a change. It was certainly enough to stop her from showing the side of herself to her new Pearl, but being strong enough to hold your emotions down isn't something that can be done for thousands of years at a time. After all, we see moments of rage returning even if she never goes into a full outburst, particularly when her pleas are being ignored by Blue and Yellow Diamond. And that, I think, was the missing piece. We now know that Pink Diamond grew up in an abusive home, one where she wasn't allowed to be herself and, by extension, wasn't allowed to be happy. It wasn't until she broke away from that home and started doing what she wanted to do, living on Earth with the Crystal Gems, that she was able to really let go of that rage she had and instead find happiness by making a new life. Without the daily reminder of what made her past so miserable there, she was able to thrive. Steven is on the same path. While his childhood may seem happy to the viewers and he wanted to be involved in Crystal Gem business, his involvement in that life is ultimately what caused him to have PTSD. The gems were loving, his father was always there for him, but allowing him to do these crazy things left a lot of emotional scars on Steven. And even being around the people he loves is just a reminder of all the suffering that he had to go through in life. And it doesn't end with the people he is close to. When the movie came out, a lot of fans were put off by Steven's new relationship with the Diamonds. It seemed overly casual considering all the terrible things that had happened between them. And on the flip side, it seemed disappointing that Steven wanted to distance himself from them as well. In the movie, it seemed to be that he found them annoying, but the truth seems much more clear now. In the episode In Dreams, we see that the Diamonds are actually still rather terrifying to him. His subconscious is bringing up different fears of his, like Spinel's injector in the background, or the Crystal Gems leaving him behind, or him being too much of a child to take care of the problems in front of him. These are all presented in humorous ways, but they hint at his very serious anxieties. We see the same pattern with the Diamonds, with a Blue Diamond Dolphin and a Yellow Diamond Pineapple, but the very terrifying threat of White Diamond's feet in the distance, something we know to be very scary because of the sheer size of the character as a villain. Steven may have a friendly relationship with them now, but it doesn't undo all the bad from before, especially since we know that White Diamond will be having some sort of villainous role in this epilogue as well. Thus far, Steven has been trying to ignore the fact that his mother even exists in this epilogue, compartmentalizing her to some distant part of his psyche so he never has to deal with her unless he really wants to. But by the end of the show, he is going to realize that his mother wasn't entirely villainous, that she grew as a person and that it's okay to be like her in some regards, such as how she dealt with her own angry emotional outbursts and childhood trauma. I don't think this means Steven will truly be leaving the show forever. If there is some HBO Max continuation, a distant movie sequel, or even just a comic book continuation, Steven will return for a reunion with the Gems, and the story would continue at Beach City or where else his new family finds themselves. But as for an ending for this epilogue series, I find it to not just be fitting, but rather beautiful. Seeing Steven take control of his life and go out into the world to figure out who he is on his own, instead of who he had to be because of the people around him, would be an amazing way to end this story. That's all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this theory, and I'll see you next time.